إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يحلل الله فلا مدل له، ومن يدلل فلا خادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذين تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وخير الحديث هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيما الناس مسلكم ونفسه بتحن الله، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون، واحتسموا بحمد الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على النبي رحمته والخدى محمد أمين وعلى آله وأصحابه طيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. All praise is indeed due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessing and salutation upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all his companions. We ask Allah to bless every single of us here. Ameen. Today's khutbah, we will be looking at the life of the great Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. He was the fourth Caliph in Islam, and he took over from Usman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, he was born in Makkah al-Mukarramah, and he was 30 years younger than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Something interesting is the man, you have to know that the man who looked after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the death of his grandfather is Ali, who was known as Abu Talib. This Abu Talib was a man who defended Islam. He defend Islam, he defend Muslims, but he did not accept Islam himself. And he had a son known as Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ali ibn Abi Talib was the cousin of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They had a very, very, very good relation from a very young age. Muhammad and Ali, they had a very good relation. And the reason is Abu Talib went through some difficult time in his life. Abu Talib, he went through some difficult times in his life. And there were a time that Abu Talib, he could not afford to take care of his children. So he decided to take two of his children to his parents, which children was that? There were two. It was Ja'far and Ali. So he decided to take two children of the three children that he had to his parents. So now he took one to Al-Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib, who was his brother, and he told him, "Will you look after one of my children?" So Al-Abbas says, "I will look after Ja'far ibn Abi Talib." He then approached Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and told him, "Will you look after one of my children?" And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "I will look after Ali ibn Abi Talib." And Ali radiallahu anhu, his age was 5 to 6 years when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam began to take care of him. So he grew up with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Khadija bint Khuwayri radiallahu anha. So they were so close. Ali used to follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wherever he went. Most places that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to go, they found Ali ibn Abi Talib walking with him as a young boy. So when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was granted prophethood by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ali ibn Abi Talib, who loved him so much, was the first from amongst the boys to accept Islam. Now here, look, listen very carefully. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he was the first from amongst the men to accept Islam. But Ali ibn Abi Talib, he was the first from amongst the boys to accept Islam. And how exactly it happened? There are two narrations how Ali accepts Islam, how he became a Muslim. One says that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu saw Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Khadija bint Khuwayli radiallahu anha reading Salah, meaning he saw them worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he asked Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Oh, ya Muhammad, what are you doing?" So Muhammad said, "I am worshipping Allah who made me. I do not worship the idols. The idols are wrong. It's wrong to do what Quraysh are doing." And then he explained to him what Islam was, and he invited him to Islam. And Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu accepted the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the second narration says, he said, "Let me talk to my father." And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "You have got to think. If you lie, you accept, but I like you to keep it to yourself for now, because I have not been instructed yet to go and tell the others. Soon as possible," Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu accepted Islam. So this is some of the narrations of how Ali ibn Abi Talib became a Muslim, but he was a young boy, about 10 years old. About 10 years old.